Dear students, in this session we will discuss problems based on a function of single random variable which follows uniform distribution. So the random variable x is uniformly distributed between 0 to 4. The random variable y is obtained from x using the relation y is equal to x minus 2 whole square. So what are the cumulative distribution function and probability density function for the random variable y, which is a function of the random variable x? So solution, so we can see that y is equal to x minus 2 whole square. This is a parabola, implies x minus 2 is equal to plus or minus root y. X minus 2 is equal to plus or minus root y. X minus 2 is equal to plus or minus root y. That means x minus 2 is equal to minus root y, or x minus 2 is equal to plus root y. So that means x is equal to minus root y plus 2, or y is equal to, or x is equal to root y plus 2. So this is the graph of this parabola. So x and y axis, this is the parabola, y is equal to x minus 2 whole square. You can see that when the value of y is less than or equal to y, then the value of x, the random variable x, lies between these two values. Therefore, f y of y actually probability that y less than or equal to y. So this will be equal to probability that if y is less than or equal to y, suppose this is y, y is less than or equal to y, then the value of x lies between minus y plus 2 and minus root y plus 2 and root y plus 2. Therefore, we can write it as probability that minus root y plus 2 is less than or equal to x, less than or equal to root y plus 2. So which is equal to f capital Fx of upper limit minus capital Fx of lower limit. So what is the lower limit? Lower limit is minus root y plus 2, because we know this probability that x1 less than x less than x2, probability that the random variable lies between x1 and x2 is Fx of x2 minus Fx of x1. Therefore, the cumulative distribution function of y is Fy of y, which is equal to Fx of root y plus 2 minus Fx of minus root y plus 2. So now we find Fx, probability density function of y, Fx of, sorry, Fy of y, probability density function of y, Fy of y is equal to derivative of d by dy of Fy of y, Fy of y, which is equal to d by dy of Fy of y is here Fx of root y plus 2 minus Fx of minus root y plus 2. So we can write this one as d by dx of, since we have x here, we can write it this one as d by dx of, x is the variable here, therefore this is a function of x. So we can write it as d by dx of this function Fx of root y plus 2 into dx by dy. So this is the chain rule, dx by dy. Similarly for the second term, minus d by dx of this function Fx of minus root y plus 2 into dx by dy. So this is using chain rule. This is equal to, because this is a composite function, so this is equal to d by dx of Fx of root y plus 2 is actually Fx of root y plus 2. Derivative of the cumulative distribution function is the probability density function into dx by dy. So what is dx by dy? So differentiate root y plus 2 with respect to y. So this function with respect to y. So derivative of root y is 1 by 2 root y minus d by dx of fx is fx of minus root y plus 2 into differentiate this function. So the function is because x is minus root y plus 2, derivative of x with respect to y is, that means this function with respect to y is minus 1 by 2 root y. Minus 1 by 2 root y, derivative of 2 is 0. Here also derivative of 2 is 0. So this much, you will get this much. So which is equal to fx of root y plus 2, 1 by 2 root y minus into minus plus fx of minus root y plus 2 into 1 by 2 root y. So this I have multiplied, minus into minus become plus. So this can be written as, because x is equal to root y plus 2, also x is equal to minus root y plus 2, this you can write as fx of x into 1 by 2 root y plus fx of x into 1 by 2 root y. So which is equal to twice, 2 times fx of x into 1 by 2 root y. So this 2 cancels, get cancels. So therefore, fy of y, probability density function of the random variable y, will be equal to fx of x into 1 by root y. So we know this fx of x, actually fx of x into 1 by root y, right? Root y. So the given, since x is random variable which follows the uniform distribution, fx of x is equal to, fx of x is equal to 1 by 4 between 0 to 4, because we know that x is the random variable which follows the uniform distribution in the interval 0 to 4. So therefore fx of x equal to 1 by 4 between 0 to 4 and 0 otherwise. Therefore fy of y can be written as, fy of y is in place of fx of x replace 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 into 1 by root y, which is equal to 1 by 4 root y. This is whenever the random variable x lies between 0 and 4. So consider the next problem. The random variable x is uniformly distributed between 0 and 2 and y is equal to 3x power 3. 3 times x power 3. So what is the PDF of y? That means fy of y. So the given function is y is equal to 3x cube. From this we can find that x is equal to y by 3 whole power 1 by 3. So that means bring 3 here. So x cube equal to y by 3. Therefore x equal to y by 3 whole power 1 by 3. So the cumulative distribution function of y is fy of y, which is equal to probability that y less than or equal to y. That means as y less than or equal to y, the random variable x is less than or equal to x. So what is that x? Y by 3 whole power 1 by 3. So this is probability, this is the cumulative distribution function fx of this value, because we know that fx of x is equal to probability that x less than or equal to x. So therefore this is fx of y by 3 whole power 1 by 3. So this is fy of y. So next we find the cumulative, probability density function. So probability density function is fy of y, which is equal to d by dy of differentiation of fy of y. So fy of y is fx of y by 3 power 1 by 3. So once again, if you use the chain rule, so derivative of fx we have to do with respect to x. That means it is d by dx of fx of y by 3, fx of y by 3 power 1 by 3 into differentiate y by 3 power 1 by 3. So derivative of y by 3 power 1 by 3 is 1 by 3 times y by 3 power 1 by 3 minus 1, that is minus 2 by 3 into derivative of y by 3. Derivative of y by 3 with respect to y is 1 by 3. So d by dx of this function into dx by dy. Differentiate x with respect to y, you will get this. So this is using chain rule. So which is equal to d by dx of this is fx of this value is what? X. So therefore this can be written as d by dx of fx of x into, so this is 1 by 3 1 by 3 1 by 3 3s are 9, and this we can take the reciprocal of this to change the sign here. So 3 by y power 2 by 3, so this is equal to, so d by dx of fx of x is f small letter f suffix x of x, this is probability density function of the random variable x, into, so since we have 3 here, I will write it as 3 square, so 1 by 3 square into 3 power 2 by 3 divided by y power 2 by 3. 2 by 3. If you simplify this, you will get fx of x into 1 by 3 power, bring this 2 by 3 to the denominator, 3 power 2 minus 2 by 3, 4 by 3 into y power 2 by 3. What is fx of x? We know that x is the random variable which follows the uniform distribution between 0 to 2, that is given in the problem. So we know that fx of x is equal to 1 by 2 when x lies between 0 to 2, 0 otherwise. This is given in the problem because the random variable x follows the uniform distribution between 0 to 2. So therefore, fy of y can be written as, this is fy of y. Fy of y can be written as fx of x in place of fx of x, I will write 1 by 2, that is when x lies between 0 to 2. 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 power 4 by 3 into y power 2 by 3. So this is the probability density function of the random variable y. Consider the problem here. The random variable x is uniformly distributed between 0 and 5. So the event b is equal to x greater than 3.7. The random variable x is greater than 3.7. Find the probability density function of x when x given b. So similarly, mu x given b, similarly that means conditioned mean, conditioned variance, conditioned probability density function. Solution. So given x is uniformly distributed between 0 to 5, therefore fx of x is equal to 1 by 5 minus 0, 1 divided by 5 minus 0, that is 1 by 5 between 0 to 5 and 0 otherwise. And b is given, b is equal to random variable x greater than 3.7. Therefore, and b is equal to x greater than 3.7. Therefore, probability of b means probability that x greater than 3.7, which is equal to probability that x greater than 3.7 is integration from 3.7 to infinity, 3.7 to infinity, but the limit is a maximum here should be 5, otherwise it is 0. Therefore we can write it as 3.7 to 5. Between 3.7 to 5, the value of the random probability density function is 1 by 5. 1 by 5 into dx, because probability that x greater than 3.7 is integration from 3.7 to infinity fx of x dx. So if you restrict the limit to upper limit to phi, then fx of x is 1 by phi, substitute here, into dx. So if you integrate and substitute the limits, you will get probability of b. Therefore probability of b is equal to 1 by phi x between the limits 3.7 to phi, which is equal to 0.26. If you simplify this, substitute the limits, upper and lower limit, simplify, you will get 0.26. Also, fx given b of x, fx given b of x is equal to fx of x divided by probability of b whenever x lies between 3.7 and x. 3.7 less than x, less than 5, and 0 otherwise. And 0 otherwise. Therefore, fx given b of x will be equal to fx of x is 1 by 5 between 0 to 5. Therefore, 1 by 5 into 1 divided by probability of b, 1 by 0.26. So, if you do the calculation, you will get 0.769 whenever x lies between 3.7 to 5, 0 otherwise. So now we will find the mean value of x given b. Mean value of x given b is given by the formula minus infinity to plus infinity x into fx given b of x into dx. So this is equal to, we are using the probability density function, this probability density function here. So which is equal to 3.7 to 5, 3.7 to 5 into x, this is x. Fx given b of x is 0.76 into 0.769. So simple integration, integration of x is x square by 2. Into 0.769, substitute the upper as well as lower limit, integrate and substitute the limits, you will get the answer 4.35. Similarly, expected value of x square given b, this is expected value of x given b, this is expected value of x square given b, is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x into fx given b, x square into fx given b of x into dx. So which is equal to 3.7 to 5, x square into fx given b of x is 0.769. so once again, if you integrate x square x cube by 3, then substitute the limits in place of x, upper limit 5, lower limit 3.7, do the simplification. So you will get the answer 19.0576. So finally we find the variance of x square given b. Variance of x square given b, which is equal to expected value of x square given b minus mu x given b, expected value of x given b whole square, that is mu x given b whole square. This is equal to 19.0576 minus 4.35 whole square. Which is equal to 0.14.